Greetings, students. Welcome back to the channel. This is Mentor Generations with Teacher Angie. And in this video, I am going to take you through the other type of continuous variation. Check out the previous videos on this continuous variation, on what variation is, and a few evaluation questions that just help you to get a grip and understanding of the unit. And yeah, so without wasting much time, I didn't ask how you're doing. I hope you are in good health, hope you're pushing on, I hope you're focusing on your dream of being successful, which I know all students want to, unless otherwise. If you don't feel motivated to learn, it's about time you just get it started, because what else do you want to do in that age, the age that you are in high school? What else do you want to do? I mean, schooling just helps to broaden your mind and just help you to survive, and it shouldn't just be for survival, but it should help you to thrive and achieve your goals and dreams, all those things you've ever wanted to do as an adult, changing lives. They better be good stuff though. Schooling is one way. It's like a ticket, it's like a key, but you gotta know how to use the key. Because if you don't, then it's going to be a waste of time and resources, which is something that I don't want for you. So yes, types of variations, and this time continuous variations. Now, these are traits or these are characteristics with intermediaries from one extreme to the other, like from one extreme to another. You can have like a wide range of, you know, parameters within these traits. By parameters, I mean examples like we have height, it's measured in centimeters, right? So you would have, say for example, the height of students in your class, the height of family members, say, you would have quite a wide range. Some of them will even be up to point whatever, it could be 0.9, 0.8, or even if it is 110 centimeters or 5'3", that's a slightly tall person. 6 inches is a very tall person, that's over 150 meters, you know. We have weight. People have quite a variety of weights. I mean, what's your weight? What's your height? You know, these are questions that you should come to your mind even as we are looking at continuous variation. Traits that have a wide range of characteristics within a particular parameter. Their intermediates are present. It's unlike the discontinuous variation where we have no intermediate forms when it comes to those traits. So examples, like I've mentioned, are height, weight. We have skin color. We have a wide range of skin colors. And yes, genetics plays a role. But the length of internal teeth plants, for example, some, if you love sugarcane, for example, you can tell the different types. Some have very short internodes, others have long internodes. And the size of leaves, the type of fruits, the size of fruits, the color of fruits, the size of flowers, the type of flowers, the form, the shape, the color. It's quite a lot. It's a wide range of traits when it comes to continuous variation. That's why the word is continuous. It's like flowing. It flows, you know. It's not like this or this, it's like a whole wide range of that. So yeah, in this case, these are traits that are basically controlled by more genes. So more genes play a role. And the physical expression, what we see, what we observe in terms of genes, these many genes that control these variations, they are also influenced by the environment. That's a difference from what we have in discontinuous variations. Okay? And another interesting thing is that when these parameters, or when the parameters within these examples are plotted, say, for example, in biology, there is a lot of plotting in terms of just getting students to master their analytical skills and interpret data in and have information within units or topics to be able to interpret data on them. you will be surprised to have a normal distribution curve. Now, what does a normal distribution curve look like? A normal distribution curve would be something like this. So you can see from the video that from this graph that we have a range. It's starting from zero and it's increasing, and we have a maximum or an optimum right there, and then it's reducing. It's like it can be any height within this range. So when plotting on a graph, you have a normal distribution curve that is steep, having a highest or an optimum or and just being something that looks like this when it's plotted. So I want us to look at a few examples of continuous variation. And yes, we have skin color, they are here, you can see them, and there are others that you see in your environment. And we have these beautiful ladies here having quite a wide range of skin colors. Yes. And then we have also another example is in the weights. Our brothers right here are overly blessed when it comes to weight, as you can see. And I think they're in some game. I think it's called sumo. I guess it's a Japanese game. It's a, like kind of like wrestling. It's not a game. It's a sport, not a game, but a sport. And we have our lady here trying to watch their weight through exercise, and this gentleman, very very muscular. I'm sure if we were to turn this picture around, it would be a massive, nicely shaped six-pack, which ladies love. Is it not true, ladies, girls? Why? Please answer in the comment section why the six-packs are loved so much. Don't ask me if I do. But if you ask me in the comment section, maybe I'll answer you. But don't leave to subscribe to the channel and like and share. And we have somebody who has successfully reduced their weights to the point that their long pants, or their, as it is called in other areas of the world, or their trousers are not fitting them anymore. They are having to take up other trousers, if I may say. So just to show weights right there, and we have the gentleman and the gentleman, different weights. This is pure example of continuous variation weights. The other example is the length of internodes. And clearly it's depicted here. There are different lengths of internodes. Yeah. Different lengths of internodes. And so there are others that are longer, there are others that are shorter. You can see this is short. I think this is for cassava plant. This is sugarcane. This is bamboo tree, which is similar to this one. So another example in plants, length of internodes. And then we have the different flowers and tree and different fruits and colors and stuff like that. So yeah, that's basically it about variations. Very, very interesting. And you may ask yourself, really, what causes variations? What causes variations? Why variations? What causes them? What causes variations? Do you ask yourself that? Have you asked yourself that? That's what I'm interested in knowing as we were going through this video. So yeah, there are many causes of variations. So many as three. Can be information. This happens during independent assortment and crossing over, fertilization, and mutations. Well, this is going to be subject of the next video. Make sure you catch up with it. And so far, so good. I hope you enjoyed this video, students, learners. I really enjoy this video myself. And I want to hope that you actually appreciate the fact that you can learn using videos and just get something to add on to what you're doing at school. That is pretty impressive. You're using IT in a way that is powerful, believe you me. So yeah, you can learn. And of course, I'm going to evaluate you on this. We're going to go through some questions together. This is Mental Generations. Thank you for watching this video. I want to appreciate your presence and moving along with me on this flight. And now as the flight touches down, thank you. Share, subscribe, and also remember to hit the notification bell so that you know when the questions arrive on a topic that interests you. And also you can tell me in the comment section the kind of videos that you would topics that you like me to cover, or whatever video that you need me to make in terms of content or anything, because believe you me, I have so much to offer and I just want the best for you. Thank you. See you in the next video. Bye bye.